Okay, so what is covered call? What is covered call? Holding a stock, buying a stock and selling the call option is covered call. And why do you use it, or what is the investment objective? What are the investment objectives? Income generation or to reduce exposure or to improvise on the market. And what is protective put? Protective put is stock plus put option. And what is the investment objective? What is the investment objective for put protective put? Downside protection. Ho sakta hai, but you will, in any case you will have maximum profit. If you only stock, if you only hold a stock, you will still have maximum profit. And what is fiduciary call? Call option plus bond. And what is put call parity? Yes, so S plus P equals C plus bond. Any confusion? Questions? Moving on, next strategy or instrument is caller. What is a caller? Let's say that you have a stock and its price is $100. So let's say that your risk is that price can fall. So if price falls, you will lose out. And if price falls to zero, you will lose out all 100. So in order to partially hedge that risk, or in order to reduce that risk, you can buy a put option. So you can buy a put option. And so let's say the put option is, you have bought it at $80. This means even if the stock price falls below $80, you will still get $80. Because you will be able to sell it at $80. When you buy a put option, you pay a premium, right? So that means you have an outflow of put option premium. So in order to reduce this loss of put option premium, what you can do is you can sell a call option. So for example, you sell a call option with $120 strike price. This means that if price goes beyond 120, you will still have a benefit up till 120. Why? Because this benefit which you have beyond 120 will be used to pay off the call option holder. So beyond this, stock will give a benefit, but call option will give a loss. So these two will offset each other. So that means if you sell a call option, you receive a premium. So you paid a premium here for put, and you received a premium for call. This is known as caller, in which you have a ceiling and a floor. So now your benefit or loss will be between 120 and 80. Maximum price for you is 120 and minimum price for you is $80. This is known as caller. And here you receive a premium and here you pay a premium. Any question so far? This can be on stock, this can be on interest rate, or this can be on any other asset. So I can also make a caller of interest rate. For example, call option on a selling a call option on a particular interest at a higher interest rate and buying a put option on a lower interest rate. So any question so far? Now if you have a premium, this premium and this premium, if these two premiums are equal, then you wouldn't have any cash flow with respect to premium. Why? because you will receive it from call and you will pay it off for to put. So if these two premiums are equal, that particular caller is known as zero based caller. Yes, it means that there is no cost of this caller. So there is no cost. Why? Because whatever premium you have to pay, you are receiving it from another end. Whatever you receive from call premium, you pay it for put premium. That means there is no cost for you to make it. Any questions, problems? So what is the objective? The objective is obviously downside protection. How do you get downside protection? Through put option. But through put option you will get downside protection, but you will have to pay some premium. So another objective is to reduce that premium loss or that premium amount, or offsetting that premium by also selling a call option. So this is the possible investment. These are the possible investment objectives of call: buying a put option to protect downside, and then selling a call option to offset the put option premium. What is the risk? Risk is opportunity cost again. Why opportunity cost? Because even if a stock goes up very high or asset price goes up, you wouldn't benefit. You have put a ceiling at 120 or whatever the price is. So as you have a ceiling, you wouldn't benefit with the extra gains. You wouldn't benefit with any abnormal gains. So this is caller. Again, what will be the value of caller? Value of caller will be value of this stock plus value of put minus value of call option. If you have a stock. Generally, when we talk about caller, it can be put minus call. So if you do not have a stock, or if you are not holding a stock, you are only holding a put option and a call option, then value of that put and call will be value of put minus value of call. Otherwise, if you also have a stock, then value, total value will be stock, value of stock plus value of put minus value of call. And remember, call option is sold and put option is bought. So the holder of a stock worth $42 is considering placing a caller on it. So that means he already have a stock, and when he puts a caller, he will buy a put option and sell a call option. A put with an strike exercise price of 40 costs 5.32. A call with the same premium. Same premium means that call's price will be 5.32. Would require an exercise price of 50.59. So this means your maximum price becomes 50.59 and your minimum price becomes 40, and currently you are at 42, and premium for both of these is same. That means there is a zero based caller, so there is no gain or loss from premium. Determine the value at expiration and profit under following outcomes. So what is the value if price of stock is 55. What is the value? Value should be value of stock plus value of put minus value of call. So if price is 55, what will be the value? If price is 55, what will be the value of stock? What is the value of stock? If stock price is 55, what is the value of stock? 55. So value of stock is 55. What is the value of put option? Yeah, so what is put option? Put option is the option to sell. So you can sell at a 40 and in market price is 55. So x minus s is negative number, that means value of put option is 0. And what is the value of call option? Sorry? Yes. And it should be negative. Why? Because you have sold the call option. So minus s minus x, 55 minus 50.59. So what will be the answer? 50.59. So if you look into it, if price goes beyond ceiling, your value will be capped at ceiling. That means value cannot increase beyond 50.59. And similarly, value cannot decrease below 40. So if price is beyond 50.59, your value will be 50.59. So you do not even need to do these calculations. Simply, if you know that price is beyond ceiling, then value will be equal to ceiling, 50.59, because this is the maximum which you can get. And what will be the profit? So you went up from 42 to 50.59. So what is your profit from stock? Profit from stock is 50.59 minus 42. Correct? And you bought the call option, so you paid a premium, and you you sold the call option, so you received the premium of 5.32. And then you bought the put option, so you paid the premium of 5.32. So as both premiums are same, these both will cancel out. Yes. Any questions? So do the part 2. The price of the stock at expiration is $48. If price is $48, what will be the value? Value will be 48 dollar. So if price is $48, value will also be $48, because value can range between 50.59 and 40. Call option here has no value, put option here has no value. So that means value is only the value of stock. Because put option value is 0, call option value is 0. So value is 48, and what is the profit? Profit. So you went up from 40 to 48. So it will be 48 minus 42 plus put option premium, plus call option premium, which is 5.32, minus put option premium, which is 5.32. So profit will be $6. So remember, in this case we have same value for put and call, but if you have it different, then profit will be different. So you need to add call option premium and subtract put option premium. So profit in this case will be 6. And for third part, which is $35, what is the value? Value will be 40. So 35 would appear here. You have a ceiling at 40. That means value cannot decrease below 40. So value will be $40. And profit will be? How much? So it dropped from 42 to 40. So that means your loss is minus 2. From 42 to 40. Minus 2, because you have a floor at 40. Plus 5.32 minus 5.32. This will be minus 2. Any questions? Your price was 42. Now it is 35. So what is the floor? Floor is 40. That means your portfolio value will not fall below 40. So 42 minus 40 is your loss. 40 minus 42 is your loss. Any questions? What is the maximum profit? Maximum profit happens when stock price goes up. And what is the maximum profit? Maximum profit will happen when stock price goes up to maximum value. And for you, what is the maximum value? For you, maximum value is the ceiling price, which is 50.59. So that means this profit will be your maximum profit, which is 50.59 minus 42. Any questions? Exactly. So it will be 8.59 then plus 5.32 minus 5.32. And what is the maximum loss? Maximum loss will happen when the stock price crashes to zero, and add stock price being zero, your floor is at 40. So that means maximum loss which you can have is a stock price falling till 40. So maximum loss will be 40 minus 42 plus 5.32 minus 5.32 minus 2. Any problem so far? What is the break-even price? So at the start, what is your gain or loss? At initiation, your gain or loss is zero. Why zero? Because you received 5.32 from call option and you paid 5.32 for put option. So your net value, net benefit at a start is zero. Net profit is zero at a start. So that means you will break even at $42. If price goes up or goes down, you will have some benefit or some loss. $42, which is the starting price, because from here if it goes up or go down, there will be some benefit or some loss. At start, your benefit is zero. So if your benefit is zero, you will break even. If at expiration it remains be zero. Otherwise, had it been a positive, you would have taken break even price as 42 minus that number. Had it been negative, you would have taken break even as 42 plus that particular price.